Hi, we're coming to you live from the ASUG Best Practices S/4HANA and BTP Summit in Phoenix, Arizona. We're on a little bit of break while most people are in educational sessions. I wanted to record a new segment for you to share some of what's happening at this event. Keynote this morning, we heard about the announcement live of SAP Datasphere. And if you want to learn more about that, be sure to check out Vitaly's segment in this news episode. But the biggest story here is all about how SAP BTP can help accelerate and enhance your S/4HANA upgrade or implementation. We're talking to a lot of people about how ABAP Cloud can play an important part of that. And on the subject of ABAP Cloud, we did a hands-on workshop yesterday, and a lot of people in the audience, although they were longtime ABAP developers, had never tried out ABAP development tools. So I just want to take this as an opportunity to remind everybody, you know, for modern ABAP, the kinds of things you can do on ABAP Cloud, like wrap development, CDS views, and so forth, you definitely want to use the ABAP development tools. That's the only supported developer tooling for that kind of environment. So if you haven't ever tried out ABAP development tools for Eclipse, or it's been a while since you installed and tried them out, I encourage you to update and give it a try. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised once you get over a bit of the learning curve, and it will make your ABAP development experience so much better. So, little tidbit coming to you here from the conference, and we'll get back to things here and having lots of great conversations with customers about how BTP can enhance your S4 implementation or upgrade.
Developer challenges are all about trying new things, having fun, and learning along the way. For this month's SAP Community Challenge, we invite you to explore and get familiar with the fundamentals of exploratory data analysis, usually called EDA, using the Python machine learning client for SAP HANA. The level of this challenge is introductory. Everyone interested in working with data is welcome to join. For the next 4 weeks, every Wednesday, you will get a new Jupyter notebook with the code that you must successfully execute. The code might be incorrect or incomplete, and it is your turn to fix it and submit your successfully completed notebook. Should you have any problems or questions working on these challenges, we are here to help you. I'm looking forward to your submissions.
Hey everybody, Josh Bentley, and for today's episode of the Developer News, I wanted to highlight a subject that I really care about here at SAP, which is open source. A lot of people may not realize just how much SAP is involved in the open source community. From the earliest days of Project Gardner and Project Kima, where we were playing around with containers and learning how to really integrate those into the SAP Business Technology Platform, we've understood just how powerful it is to have the community giving us feedback, opening issues, and really working on open sourcing the code that can help enable what you as SAP developers need from us. That being said, there are two areas that I wanted to highlight for you that you may not realize that our own open source teams are working on. We have a podcast series hosted by my friend Karsten Hohag, and he sits down and interviews two of the guys involved with the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, CAP, Daniel Hutzel and Kristen Gorgi. In this podcast, they talk about all things CAP and CDS and lots of things that go into actually making CAP such a powerful tool at SAP, and they also talk about the plans and the status of open sourcing the Cloud Application Programming Model to all the SAP developers out there. So please tune in and listen to this podcast and all the other podcasts and the series from the open source team. Next, I wanted to highlight there's a webinar coming up on March 28th at 3 o'clock Central European Time, 9 o'clock Eastern Time. This webinar is going to be diving into how we actually do the cloud SDK. Please join Marika Marzalowski, a senior developer in the area of cloud development, as she takes us through this webinar to explore the SAP Cloud SDK for JavaScript, an open source library that simplifies developing web applications on SAP's business technology platform. There's lots of webinars, and again, there's a series of podcasts you can listen to, so please stay up to date with all the great things coming out of the SAP Open Source Program Office.
Those of you like me who are fans of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, and that's CAP to you and me, will be pleased to know that the February 2023 release of the CAP framework is now out. While there are fewer announcements this time around because the team are working on the next annual major release, there are still plenty of features of interest. In the CDS language and compiler area, specifically in the area of spatial functions, there's new support for instantiation and instance method call syntax. For Java language support, there's a new streamlined deployment service which covers all tenant lifecycle events, and also the former MT subscription service is now deprecated. In the area of tools, there are some cool innovations in relation to CAP notebooks, which are visually interactive REPL-style work areas supported by VS Code. You can now launch CAP notebooks directly from the CAPIA documentation. A new button will be visible when there's one available relating to the particular CAP feature that you happen to be reading about. What's more, there are new CAP notebook samples available as well. Also in the area of tooling, there is a new async API export facility which allows you to document your events in your CAP project in the async API format. There are also updates in relation to running CAP on Kima, Kubernetes, specifically relating to the connectivity service and also in relation to Helm charts. You can read all about details of these features in the usual place, the CAPIA documentation website.
This week, we at SAP announced SAP Datasphere, a comprehensive data service built on the SAP Business Technology Platform. SAP Datasphere is the next generation of SAP Data Warehouse Cloud, but with new capabilities that enhance data discovery, modeling, and distribution. This includes a new data catalog that acts as a centralized repository describing all the data and metadata, including lineage and governance. State-of-the-art data flow capabilities, which allow organizations to automatically generate pipelines at the enterprise scales and enrich the business semantic data layer. Existing SAP Data Warehousing Cloud customers will automatically see new functionality in their product environment today. No migration necessary. You can try SAP Datasphere instantly with a free tier of SAP BTP.